This is one of the last undisturbed cloud forests on Earth, located on the island of Papua New Guinea. There are no roads here, no airports, and little communication with the outside world. It is truly remote. And just below you there, a couple of large tents wedged amongst the trees, that's the Wassanon Field Camp. Here, a team of researchers are studying one of the most elusive animals in the forest, the Machi's tree kangaroo. The research team with the Tree Kangaroo Conservation Project is making their way through the dense rainforest. They're hoping to locate and radio collar a tree kangaroo in order to unlock the mysteries of this rare and unusual animal. Tree kangaroos live high up in the canopy, and finding them is no easy task. You can walk right underneath one without ever knowing it was there. The team has managed to capture a tree kangaroo. A radio collar is placed on the new study animal. Measurements are taken, and its health assessed.
She's much better about it.
Once finished, the animal is placed in a burlap sack and brought to the base of a tree to be released back into the wild. Once the animal is out of the bag, it all happens rather fast. Tree kangaroos are remarkably agile climbers. The information these collars provide is critical to the conservation of the species. Just over the mountains from where a tree kangaroo was released, is the tiny village of Yawan. This is one of several mountain communities that have joined together to create one of the largest protected cloud forests in Papua New Guinea. And all of this is made possible by coffee. Small coffee gardens are scattered around the village. And right now, it's harvest time. Everyone is out picking the ripe coffee cherries. Each garden is owned by a single family, but together with many other families in the surrounding villages, they have formed a coffee cooperative.
Thank you.
After the cherries are picked, the coffee seeds are extracted, washed, and eventually dried. Sales from the coffee bean support the local community, providing them with healthcare and education. For these remote mountain communities, coffee has become a sustainable alternative to more destructive forms of income, such as timber or mining. On occasion, local farmers even roast their own beans over an open fire. The coffee is crushed and brewed in a kettle, producing one of the best cups of coffee you might ever taste. But what makes this coffee so much sweeter is the good it's doing for these local communities and the wildlife that surrounds them.